You're not gonna comment on how weird that got? Are you just that used to my weird shenanigans that we're just like, Kyle's just vibing in here, jigging?
Yeah.
That wasn't weird to you?
I am. Did y'all see this?
See what? Oh, I saw.
Oh, the little boy.
Oh, it's awful.
Smack him.
Awful.
Yeah, little boy was hanging. You see him drop down?
Awful.
He's in critical condition.
Awful. Which boy?
No, the one to the left. There was one to the left.
I didn't see the one to the
left.
Yeah,
look, what?
No, stop.
Hanging out to the left.
Shut up.
And you can see his body kind of lip fall down right
shut
there.
Shut up.
Yeah, I know that kind of brought the sound.
Oh, Lord Jesus. What's up, y'all? Welcome to Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks. My name is Mel. In studio with Kyle Wallace. Also, we got Benjamin on the ones and twos.
It's amazing.
So we're, we have the news up here in studio. And of course, we're coming at you live from the American Family Insurance Studio here at the Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee. I don't know how many of y'all saw, but yesterday morning there was a crash in front of Morris Middle School involving a stolen Kia. It was a white Kia, and it smacked the back of a bus so hard. The bus lifted on top of the car. There was a person hanging out of the passenger seat window when the crash occurred. So this driver, this reckless driver, who was a child, I believe a 15-year-old child was the one that was driving.
15?
Yes, and then I think, I don't want to say the wrong ages, but either way, it was a child that was taken to the hospital and a child that was driving the car.
Yeah, I mean, they're all babies. They're all under.
They're all babies.
16 and under.
An 11-year-old that was actually on the bus was also taken to the hospital. He is not in critical condition. But what I was going to say, the kiddo, the poor sweet baby that was hanging out of the passenger side, the driver was so reckless, y'all, that it looked like it was an intentional crash. It looked like
he lost control.
Did he lose control?
He's 15. He does not
so
have
you
his
think
license.
He just lost control.
Yeah, if you're going 70 miles per hour and then you're trying to hang out windows and doing all the stuff, and
so
you're
you think
swerving.
The driver was also hanging out the window?
Well, I think the driver just lost control. Somebody was hanging out the back window.
Yeah, you're right. But either way, the driver lost control or veered into the bus. That bus, literally smacked the back or the car smacked that bus so hard that the bus went on top of where the kid was hanging out of the passenger side. So, sending prayers to that poor, sweet baby. I know he was involved in a stolen car theft,
he's still a kid,
and it makes me sick. He's a boy. He's a little boy. So prayers to him.
We just got to find something. We got to find something productive. Because
this
is tragic to see on film.
Horrible.
And I hope what they do, I hope at every school today, every single school that there may have been a Kia boy at, I hope and pray that they show this horrific video so people understand the ramifications of our actions. And what may seem fun and innocent in the moment, and most of the times it may end up just being an innocent, hey, we stole a car and we left it and we had fun. But there are tragedies that occur and it can be anybody. Because right now there are families, there are friends, and there are people connected to this incident that are hurt and are struggling. So it just, you know, sometimes you need this traumatic thing to see that you don't want to see, but sometimes you need that in order for people to understand the risk that they are taking and putting their life at.
No, absolutely. Appreciate you saying that, Kyle. And, you know, listen, y'all, we understand y'all are taking your lunch breaks right now. Y'all are probably, you know, on some sort of reprieve from your work day. And the last thing that we want to, you know, come at you with at the start of the show is something as horrific as that. But to
Kyle's
point,
blame them, TMJ4.
And I know they're the ones that. But no, Kyle, but for real, to that point, though, I was going to actually go along with what you said. As difficult as it is to watch those kind of things, it's important to know what's going on. And it's important for these kids that are potentially involved to see that type of stuff. Like, I truly do believe that they do not understand the ramifications of their actions usually. Like, the full scope of it. I'm talking his boy is critically hurt. Like, he's in the hospital with some serious life-threatening injuries. They need to realize it's their own homies, it's their friends, their family that can very well be affected by this. And I'm talking not just the ones that are affected, you know, outside of it, but the ones that are riding with you in the car. Like, y'all are putting your lives at risk. And I think they hopefully probably understand that. And I do know, by the way, that that's part of the thrill, unfortunately. If you watch the Kia Boys documentary that's on YouTube, which we have talked about at length, especially when it dropped last year, But if you watch it, one of the things that they say, well, death is inevitable. And it's like, okay, I'm right, it is. If there's anything that's final in life, it's death. But why would you call upon it when you're 13, 14, 15 years old? You have so much of your life to live. And that's what really bothers me about that type of sentiment, because sure, while it's true, you haven't even begun to live your life. Why would you call death to your door when you haven't even fully seen what life has to give you? Life is so much bigger than what's happening in your own backyard, than what's happening in the neighborhood a few streets away from you. Like, there is a great wide oasis that you could potentially be a part of. And I feel like so many of these kids, they limit themselves because they feel that because the generations that came before them, or their neighbors, or, you know, their peers, whoever it may be, because they only see so much of life, they feel like they are limited as well. But the sky is the limit, and you have to recognize that you are bigger than the situation that you're in. You are a creature of your environment, but you don't have to stay in that environment. You can become bigger and better than the environment that you were born into. And I think so many of them just don't realize that.
And as you say this, Mel, I think, you know, on Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris, they had the Truth Roundtable where Lornell Ramey was there, who's part of Mentor MKE. And I think what you're saying now is such a strong message in the platform that you have, is that we talk about redoing education and trying to find a way to make sure specifically at MPS we get more graduates. And I think something else that we need to think about is we need to think about the importance of having mentorship and role models. And maybe they need to think about having a time once a month, or maybe even more than that, where forget math, forget science, forget reading, forget all that stuff. Let's focus on how we can bring in somebody powerful like a Melanie Ricks, who you see doing her thing. You see her at the Bucks game. You hear her on the radio. You see her on TV for PKSD. You see her doing all these great things, and now she's coming in front of you and spending her time to encourage you and talk about bringing positivity. But maybe they need to carve out more time for that, so students get a chance to see who they can potentially be and what they can become, and that people care. Because I think what you said just is so powerful, and for them to be able to hear from somebody like you, a young Black woman that's doing anything, I think would be powerful. So.
Well, thank you for saying that. I feel the same way about you, Kyle. I feel the same way about Benjamin. I mean, and I would love to. Let us know. I mean, if that's something where we need to be the ones to, you know, whether it's as a team or individually, reach out to these schools. I would love to talk to these kids, Kyle. I will be very honest with you, though. My fear, and I shouldn't allow fear to, you know, get in the way. But my fear would be that I wouldn't be able to reach these kids. I wouldn't be able to get through to them. But honestly, it's like, even if you get through to one, that's better than none.
No, that's very true. And you're also relatable. It's so often that, you know, with anything in life where you see your teacher, the person in your school that you see all the time, that message gets old, you know? Right. And so seeing somebody come in who's different, shake things up a little bit, sometimes I believe in your orator, your ability to speak, will captivate them as well. So that's why I think getting the right person to come in to be that role model, it's just something that these schools need dearly and our kids need dearly, because they need to know people care about them and they can be, like you said, more than what is in this parameter or whatever it is they're doing right now. Life is bigger than what you're just doing in this moment. There's something larger that you're working to.
No, absolutely. It's so important. When you're a kid, your viewpoint is so stifled. I mean, you want to talk about adults being only able to see through such a narrow lens. Kids, it's even more narrow. Like, they truly only know what they are shown, what is given to them, what they are told. Like, very seldom do you have a child who is going to think outside the box and look outside the box and try to find, and I don't say that to say that, you know, kids are dumb or kids are limited, but they're kids. Right. Their brains have only developed so much. They only know so much. We, as the adults around them, we have to be that guide. We have to be that resource, that positivity, that beacon for them, that beacon of hope, and that realization that, again, there is so much more to life than what they know. There's more to life than what we know. And I feel like by us mentoring these kids, we'll learn a lot about ourselves and learn a lot about the world around us as well. So I couldn't agree with you more, Kyle. And it's so frustrating when you see these kind of news stories, but I pray that this is a conversation that hopefully will resonate in one, two, or more people. And I pray that, you know, you have conversations with your kiddos tonight, with the youth, and whether it's your child or, you know, a cousin or a friend or, you know, just somebody that you know. I'm telling you, y'all, just one conversation can change so much. It can change your neighborhood, your community, and the world eventually. Obviously, it's not going to change things overnight, but it's so important that we continue to have these conversations. And unfortunately, keep up with these news stories. Because, yeah, it sucks. I don't want us to be talking about this. I'm going to tell y'all right now, the three of us, you know, and obviously the conversations are always going to vary, but I think the three of us are on the same page in that we want to come to y'all with some good, hard hitting, but not hard hitting like in a negative way, like hard hitting as in like, what's hot, what's popping, what's going on, what do y'all want to talk about right now kind of thing. Like, we don't want to come and bring somber, negative news to you. But this is happening. It's in our face. There's a reason why that story was on. There's a reason why we started the show with this conversation. I wasn't even looking at the screen, but you were drawn to it, Kyle. And I'm appreciative that you were, because I really do hope that this conversation will resonate with someone and that there will be some sort of change that we see out of it. And I know that it doesn't just start here, but this can be a starting point for somebody. So really appreciate y'all saying that. Real quick. I got a few talk to text, so want to go ahead and read these before we break and get into the conversation that we do want to have today. So LT said, those kids were supposed to be in school at that time. How are you supposed to reach them if they're not even showing up for school? And they are definitely not babies. LT, I'm going to tell you right now, my definition of a baby is anybody who's a minor, anyone under the age of 18. Shoot, sometimes I even feel like some college students are still babies because they're still so childlike. Like, I was childlike in college, even though I thought I was grown. Listen, I was still very childlike, but that's a good point. What do you respond to that, Kyle?
Okay, babies, yes, that might be extreme, but young, they are still children. They are still young. And the last thing I want to do with any black children is I don't want to age advance them or make them seem more mature than what they are, because I always go back to the way they villainize the victim in the case of Trayvon Martin, where they made it out like as if he wasn't a 17-year-old kid, as if he wasn't walking home from going to a store like any kid does. And so the last thing I'm ever going to do is ever try to make a child, a black child, seem older than what they are, because society already does that enough and already makes us out to be these terrible people by the age of 16, 15, 14. Even though a lot of us are young at 14,
for sure.
15, you're still a child.
For sure.
So, okay, they're not a baby, but they are a child. They are still are young. They still are immature. They still have a lot of growth and life to live. So that's why I didn't object to you saying baby, because heck, they are. I mean, a lot of they are baby, they're kids.
Yeah, and it obviously that word baby, it's subjective. I'm just that way.
But
like,
I get what
you're
saying. You're not saying
way.
Like a toddler.
No, I don't mean that way.
Little kids that like, have so much to
learn. Yeah, they just I don't know. Kids just are so precious. Like, I really do view kids as such precious beings, because you're only a child for so long. Kids were the last ones to be close to God. You feel me? Like, I feel that way about babies. Babies were just with him, and now they're with us. Like, that's amazing to me, but we're not going to get into that conversation. What I was asking you, though, Kyle, how do you feel about what LT questioned, which was, how are you supposed to reach these kids if they're not even showing up for school?
Oh, yeah, that's a great point, because when I first saw the video, I said, dang, this happened. It's supposed to be in school. I mean,
because this was at, like, 9 a.m. I'm like, why are they not in school right now?
I mean, maybe they're in school the day that you're there. I don't really have a response to that. I mean, I would hope that these kids would be in school once in a while and somebody can try to find them. I mean, I'm not gonna try to dismiss a complete idea because maybe the kids weren't in school that day. Those kids may not be habitually truant. I mean, maybe they're, I don't know. I mean, maybe there's some way. Let's try to find a way that we can connect with them. That's all I'm saying.
Period. No, I agree. 833-212-1017. Let us know if you have any thoughts about that. We are going to get into a different conversation on the other side. Let me go ahead and tease it a little bit before we talk about some things going on with American Family Insurance. So here's your tease. So I want to know, when you are trying to impress, whatever that means, whether it's dressing to impress, educating yourself on something, you know, being in certain environments, whatever it may be, in your idea of making an impression and trying to impress someone, who is it that you are trying to impress? Is it the opposite sex? Are you trying to impress the same sex? Is it yourself? I want to know, who is it that you are trying to impress when you find yourself going above and beyond in whatever fashion in your life? 833-212-1017. That's what the conversation is about today. The reason why I want to know, do you view yourself, if you're a woman, do you view yourself through the male gaze? Do you view yourself only through your lens? Are you trying to impress other women? Because really, their opinions are the ones that matter, since women know women. And then obviously, vice versa for men. Let us know, who is it that you are trying to impress when you are getting into that mode? And as you get ready to text us at 833-212-1017, I want to say here's to the Living Room Dance Studios and to the Backyards hosting victory celebrations, to the mini bands doubling as dance team buses, and all the SUVs serving as victory parades. American Family Insurance protects your house and your car because they know they mean more than that. They're the launching pad to your dreams, and now you can save up to 23% when you bundle home and auto. Get a quote, find an agent, and learn about their discounts simply by going to amfam.com. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, SI and its operating companies, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin. American Family Insurance, insure carefully. Dream fearlessly.
Milwaukee, it's Denise Thomas.
And Telly Hughes from Truth Be Told on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
We want to make sure you join us every Friday morning at 8 a.m. for our Black Friday shout-out powered by We Energies.
Black Friday is your opportunity to call into 101.7 The Truth and shout out your Black-owned business and let Milwaukee know what you have to offer.
So hit us up every Friday at 8 a.m. to shout out your Black-owned business on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly.
They, of course, have never met in person. Ricardo has been stuck in Canada. How do you get stuck in Canada?
He went there for a job.
I go to Canada all the time. I never been stuck. Does he know you're here?
No, he does not.
Surprise! You go to food banks, but you're feeding his Beverly Hills maid.
Yes.
What kind of no good son of a bitch will take money from a woman? All new Dr. Phil.
Hi, I'm Natalie Shepard.
And I'm Jessup Reisbeck from the CBS 58 News at 10.
We hear it all the time from viewers. Television news is too negative.
That's why we're trying something different at CBS 58. In our newscasts, we focus on what's important to Southeast Wisconsin, and that's not necessarily crime.
We want you to know the great things happening in our hometowns as well.
What's going to help solve problems here and uplift our viewers?
We are your hometown station, and that's the type of news we're going to bring to you.
Join us every night at 10 on the CBS 58 News.
Are you looking for a job? Then Greater Milwaukee Urban League is the place to be. Join them on Wednesday, May 17th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. for their Working Wednesday job fair featuring jobs from some of Milwaukee's biggest manufacturers. Find out about available jobs for assembly line workers, machine operators, general laborers, warehouse and landscapers, plus get training information on other jobs including carpentry, highway maintenance, and other positions. Get more information at tmul.org and join them on Wednesday, May 17th at GMUL's main office at 435 West North Avenue.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
Literally one call, that's all.
I made one call and that's all, worry free.
One call, that's all. It worked.
Just one call and that's all.
They will do what they say they're gonna do. One call and that's all.
One call, that's all means security.
It's literally one call, that's all.
It's a phrase we'll never forget.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
This is 101.7 The Truth, Dr. Ken Harris, and the time is now, Milwaukee. You know, perspective is essential. What I found is the news behind the news is more important. I want you to leave my show with a sense of knowing what was missing that adds depth to the conversation. Tune in Monday through Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth app, or 1017thetruth.com.
You are listening to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Stop. Yeah. Can't stop, won't stop, never stop. Can't stop, won't stop, never. Can't stop, won't stop, bad boy. Always upgrading from my last. I don't f*** on Risha, Keisha, and Joy. And I ain't tripping if you give me any joy. I was locked 23 and 1. Now I ball like 23 and 1. Sniper game, I'm always playing manhunt. I'm the one who killed the fool and what. Still got the fire in my eyes, but I changed though. Suck my d***, I'm too rich to drive a Range Rover. Let hate a baby, I remember stealing mangoes. How my side better than my
man. How my side requesting this one. I was actually telling Kyle, I know y'all don't want to hear this, but believe it or not, there are people in this world who do not know what song this samples. Don't even know the group. And it sounds so much like his dad's track. I almost want to play it on the other side. But either way, this is lit. He killed this.
And King, he did.
I like King Combs.
I don't know any other song.
You don't?
No.
He has some good songs, but I always compare him to his dad.
And his dad wasn't like the best rapper. He had a little swag to him.
I mean, I was going to say, he had
He had some swag.
He had swag. I mean, he had great beats. Did he have a full album by himself rapping?
I don't think so.
No, because he was more of a producer. Yeah, he's more of a DJ. Well, not even a DJ Khaled. I don't even know who to compare him to.
He's a genius. That's what he is.
Yes, he is a genius.
He knows how to find artists and knows how to promote them.
Yes, he does. Bad Boy for Life. Period.
Five greatest rappers of all time, Ben. Who are they?
Not
Jay-Z, 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 and Jay-Z.
Dylan, Dylan, Dylan.
That's basically what he just did. Y'all are crazy.
It's the rock.
It's the rock in the building. All right. Well, we all know that the actual answer is Weezy F Baby. Please say the baby. But that's a conversation for a different day.
Or is it Drake or Kanye? I don't know.
Well, yeah, they're up there. Of course, it's Wayne. It's Jay-Z. It's Kanye. It's Drake. And it's Kendrick.
Kendrick, yeah.
Tupac, Biggie.
I honestly think it's unfair to even
longevity
bring them.
Longevity has to play a role.
Because music has changed so much, we didn't even get enough of them in order to put them with the people that we're seeing today. It's
the
just
people
unfair.
That we're seeing today would not even be here.
Wait a minute.
That's fair.
For Biggie
That's fair.
Or Pop.
Wait a minute. Now think about it. Think about if Wayne would have passed away in his prime after only having 5 years, Wayne would go down as the greatest rapper of all time.
I'll give you that.
And so all I'm saying is this, longevity matters.
Longevity does matter.
So who knows? Biggie might be a scrub now. You know, people might not
Bro,
be
you're not
finna,
you're not finna or, get or, on these airwaves and disrespect Big.
No, I'm just saying.
We just came back with a Bad Boy sample.
I'm just saying, okay? Pac and Biggie, in 2020, they may not have been popping anymore. They may be seen as old dudes that's way past their prime, and they fizzled out. Remember, 50 Cent was cold when he first started. I mean, 50 was no.
50 was definitely hot, but you know
50
what?
50 was hot,
and he fizzled out. I'm just saying.
The only reason he fizzled out.
Well, no, because he wanted to act.
Exactly.
No,
honestly, that played a role.
Said we can't put Kendrick over Cole. Where does J. Cole fall?
Oh, J. Cole is underneath Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, all right. So he's six? Like, would you replace Drake with him?
No.
Hell no.
I'm just asking a question.
J. Cole, you got some of my favorite music. Comes from you, all right? But at the end of the day, you said it yourself. You are not number one or two. You're number three. And you know that's how the world views you, all right?
Cole said that?
Cole said this.
So who, Jay-Z and Wayne over him?
No, he was saying Drake and Kendrick is over him. he made a whole record about this.
That's cute.
This is real.
I like that.
K-Dot.
All right. Y'all need to stop. I hate when y'all do this.
You started.
I didn't
you
start
really
it.
Did start
you,
this.
You, I did.
You
start
did. You did.
Right.
I just,
right.
I just had to throw the joke out
my
there
me,
with
my
Dylan.
Me. All right, Dylan.
Jay-Z, I won't disrespect my guy Jay-Z.
No, hey, I want to watch Chappelle's show. All right, real talk though. We're not talking about who you think are the best rappers of all time, though we probably should have a show about that now. We're talking about who do you try to impress when you are getting done up? And for the record, I think a man dressing up, if you will, that's the best phrase I'm going to use right now for it, a man's version of like dressing up and showing out is very different from a woman's. I'm going to be very, very transparent. This conversation stems from one that the three of us, we were having off air. I was filling in my eyebrows and I was telling the guys, just so you know, I recently had my eyebrows like tinted and shaded. And that was really fun trying to explain to them what that was. But I was telling them, yeah, I had it tinted and shaded. And ever since, I feel the need to fill in my eyebrows because I actually have very thin eyebrows. Like, I've just always had thinner eyebrows. And I wish they were a little bit thicker because I think it makes my face look better. And to me, it just makes me more presentable to the world. But then I started, like, saying, like, but who am I doing that for? Am I doing it for myself? Am I doing it so that other people think that I look better? Because I know for a fact, Ben did notice when I had them done, and only because they were so much darker and thicker, I don't think y'all would notice if I didn't fill in my eyebrows right now. Do you think that you would? Like, the way I fill it in now, not how it was when I had them done.
I mean, honestly, I would pick it up, you know. I'm attentive to all you all, you know. So
that's true.
As soon as you did have your eyebrows, I was like, man, what's up with your eyebrows? Something's going on. I see something's different. What's going on with your eyebrows? And then she told me, you know, she got them tinted and darkened them up. Okay, it brought our face a little bit more, you know. So I mean, but at the end of the day, who are you getting looking all good for? You know, who do you dress up for?
Ben, that's
is it just for you or is it for the next person or? You know, potential date? What is it?
So, you know what's funny? I think that who I get dressed up for is situational. It depends on what I'm doing. First off, I'm a textbook definition single woman. And I say textbook definition because...
Like your face could be in the book?
Well, no. Oh, my God.
I mean, like you're the example. That's what it sounded like to me.
That's I like that you said that. No. By textbook definition, I mean, depending on who you ask, maybe I'm not single, but by textbook definition, I am single.
Listening. I hope he is,
Kyle.
Brother, I do have a community for males who have been harassed and forgotten about. So if you need any support, I am here to support you.
Whatever. So point is, I am technically single, right? So when I get cute, when I wear like a cute outfit, I'm low-key doing it because I may meet my husband that day, sure. But I also operate under this like umbrella, and my mom gets so mad at me for saying this. I don't feel that my husband is in Milwaukee. I like genuinely don't think I'm gonna meet the love of my life here. I have that feeling in my bones. And my mom gets so mad at me because she's like, why would you say that? Because now you're keeping him away from you. Your energy is...
He could actually be a Kia boy. He could be a Kia boy. Wait a minute. Know.
See, Ben.
On the road.
Ben, I'm not going to take you serious.
A graduated Kia boy.
He's 18 now. He was a Kia boy in 2020.
Like, not in 2023.
You have officially made it so that I can't take you serious for the rest of this conversation. You know that, right?
All I'm saying is don't limit your options, okay? There's plenty potential
Notice
mates out
there.
Notice
that Kia boys are minors, for one.
No, not all of them.
I'm glad that you think I'm a predator, Ben.
No,
that's
look,
what you're saying.
Some of them graduated and they went on to college, okay? And they're doing their thing.
And he came back.
Okay.
They former Kia boys, man. You got to be very specific.
I guess former Kia boy, ex-Kia boy. But all I'm saying is, Mel, don't limit your options. He may be in Milwaukee, just not right here at the 3rd Street Market Hall waiting for you.
Well, point is, Ben, I don't think he's here at all. And my mom gets mad at me because she's like, well, of course he's not going to be here then. Of course you're not going to meet him if you have that energy. But even though I feel that way, I still want to be cute and like, you know, because you just never know who you're going to meet. But then I think to myself, I'm like, I feel like I'm getting cute for myself because this is not an outfit that I think a man would approach me in. I don't. I'm just
You'd
being
be surprised.
Honest.
I can't. You'd be surprised.
I'm just
wait,
being honest.
Wait,
like,
what
I
about
think
this outfit would a man not approach you in?
I don't look at this as like a sexy Here,
sexy.
It.
You don't necessarily have to have a sexy outfit on for a man to approach
you,
though.
I feel like
you
do
hair
have to be
tie,
sexy.
Sweatpants, chilling with no
makeup on.
No, that's when you're the prettiest.
I hope that you don't take it wrong.
August 30 better play that.
You guys are so yeah, he better.
I'm just saying.
You guys are so full of crap because I genuinely feel like guys.
What?
No, I'm just. That's
we,
how
we
I feel.
Being real. Well, forget your feelings. Okay. You're talking to two men right now, and we're letting you know. Okay.
So in this outfit, be very. Try to be very honest. Would you approach a woman, not necessarily me, a woman, if you found her attractive, but if she was wearing this outfit, would you approach her?
See, the key word is you found her attractive. Yeah. If I found her attractive, I'm going to go talk to her.
Yeah. So no matter what she's wearing, you're going to talk to her.
I mean,
jogging pants.
If she looked disheveled and all messed up, then I wouldn't be attracted to her. But if she's attractive, I'm not
What if
really
she's cute in the face, but her clothes aren't exactly your cup of tea?
She's a tip drill.
Stop it, Ben. No, stop it, Ben. A tip drill is the opposite of that.
It was a joke. It was a jokey joke.
I'm not taking him seriously today.
You don't have all these puns and stuff, but I can't come with a joke.
Because your jokes are like cutthroat. Like, they'll stab somebody. My gosh. Anyway.
I would say, I mean, based off the looks, I mean, bummy looking, like, clothes matter. Clothes are part of the attractiveness. And what you have on would be attractive. If a woman had that on, that's attractive. Now, if she had on some, you know, I'm thinking some shorts that I don't know. If she was dressed more, I don't know, with some shorts that were a little bit like I can't even describe. If you're attractive, you're attractive. That's what it comes down to.
That's really what it comes down to.
And what you have on is fine. But if you look like a hobo or a homeless person, then yeah, I wouldn't be attracted to you. But if you got on sweatpants or baggy clothes, that can be very cute and attractive. What you have on can be very cute and attractive. And so I don't know. What you have on is decent and fine.
I mean, in all honesty, one of the sexiest attires I can ever see a woman wear is a wife beater and some jogging pants. I'm not even going to lie.
In the streets, though?
I'm capping. That's
what?
Cap. That's
no,
cap.
It's not cap,
cap
at all.
That's you calling capping it right now.
I am telling the truth. I express my feelings. Well, look, no, I'm actually Captain Hooks, all right?
If you're going, Captain Hooks.
Yeah. Put some respect upon that.
My bad.
But no, I'm just putting my feelings out there. And honestly, that's one of the sexiest things I could see a woman wear. I love a woman with a nice wife beater on and some sweatpants or some leggings. You know, I like the simplicity. See, and I think that's the thing that a lot of times women look over. Men, we are so simple. All the eyebrows and eyelashes and hair extensions that you guys put on.
Like that.
Yeah, we don't really care about it. It doesn't fast and it's that much. It's nice for a night, maybe two, but eventually I want to get to know the real you. I got to see the real you if I'm going to be with it forever.
Ain't that fact? That's so true. He's spitting right now. He's spitting.
Hold on now. Y'all, I love to hear that y'all are spitting and doing all the things, but how many times have I said to you guys, most of the things that us women do to alter our bodies are for men because we feel as if men only like certain things about women, like fuller lips, bigger butts, bigger boobs.
Those are assets that we do like, but you don't need to have that. Those aren't requirements for everybody. Men have specific requirements that they have, but all men are not specific. All men do not have these specific things that they want. And so we have a variety of tastes that we have. For me, I like a thick girl that got a little bit of rump and shake in the back. But if a girl ain't got rump and shake in the back, but she has a pretty face and other things to offer, I'm good with that. I am not, what is it? I do not discriminate against women.
Okay.
I like all women's shapes and different sizes. Right. Like, I'm good with it.
Right.
Okay.
A pretty face is what gets me, though. Like, that is the absolute thing. And mm-hmm. you have to be cute without makeup on. If you don't look good without makeup on, I can't have it.
Yeah. Period. That's serious. And like I say all the time, I'm a sapiosexual. I get turned on by intellect. So, you know, it's just one of those things, man, where...
Is that what that is? Sapiosexual is someone who's turned on by intellect?
Yes. That is the most sexiest thing. Go ahead.
I believe you. I just need to, like, confirm it.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. I'm a sapiosexual. I fall underneath the... Never mind. I'm not going
to
go there.
Don't go there. If you have to stop yourself, don't go there, Ben.
Nope.
Cut him. Hey, cut your own mic. Let us know. When you are trying to dress to impress, when you're getting done up, are you doing it for yourself, the opposite sex, the same sex, whatever you're attracted to? Like, who are you doing it for? For yourself, you're doing it for people who look like you, or are you doing it for whomever you are attracted to? I just want to know what y'all are thinking when you are trying to dress up, because I like to look good in general always, but I will wear certain outfits, y'all. I'm not kidding you, because in my mind, a man is likelier to approach me in a certain outfit. So I'm fascinated to hear y'all say it doesn't necessarily matter what she's wearing. If you're attracted to her, you're going to approach regardless. Like, that fascinates me. So I want to hear, what do you do and who do you do it for? When you are dressing up, when you're dressing to impress, whatever that looks like on you, who are you doing it for? 833-212-1017. I also have another question for you. Are you tired of paying rent to a landlord and not yourself? Well, you can team up with Axe Housing just like I did so that you can become a homeowner finally. They have already helped over 3,000 families to buy their own home, and you can be next. Oftentimes, your mortgage will be less than your rent, and the average family that Axe has helped has a mortgage around $800 a month. A skirt? That's cheap, y'all, especially compared to these rent prices. So make sure you check out axehousing.org right now. They've got coaches that are ready to help you and your family find the best path to home ownership. No restrictions on who can access the program. Just visit axehousing.org today. And if you're a general contractor looking for work, they also are in need of you. Make sure you hit up axehousing.org right now.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Dr. Ken Harris, and the time is now, Milwaukee. You know, perspective is essential. What I found is the news behind the news is more important. I want you to leave my show with a sense of knowing what was missing that adds depth to the conversation. Tune in Monday through Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth app, or 101.7thetruth.com.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community, and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth. Milwaukee, Black. Talk.
This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Justice is about receiving what we deserve. Quote Audre Lorde, who said, "There is no such thing as a single issue struggle because we do not live single issue lives." And that said, any freedom, including reproductive freedom, is our human right to decide what is best for our own lives. Reproductive freedom is about having bodily autonomy, which is the same as being able to control what happens to our bodies, including the decision to continue or terminate a pregnancy, rest with the pregnant person, at all times and in all circumstances. Because when rights don't apply to all individuals and at all times, they are not rights. They are not rights. And as Black people, our rights are conditional way too often. Whether we're talking about during police encounters, quality housing, or, you know, some job opportunity.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth.
We dropped our bags, grabbed a coffee, and headed straight for the shops where I found these amazing souvenirs. Then we chatted with the locals who pointed us towards this fantastic bistro for lunch.
Wow, your vacation sounds amazing.
Oh, that was just our trip through the terminal. Our flight to Cabo is boarding now. Bon voyage!
With super convenient parking and low fares on nonstops nationwide, flying from the Milwaukee airport makes traveling so easy. It's like starting your vacation early. Fly easy. Fly MKE.
Attention families, Milwaukee Public Museum wants to remind you that Kohl's Thank You Thursdays are in full swing. Receive free admission to MPM on the first Thursday of every month. Milwaukee Public Museum would like to thank Kohl's for their support and making this program possible. Visit MPM's website today for more information and to book your reservation. mpm.edu/KTYT. That's mpm.edu/KTYT.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Greg Matzik. The Green Bay Packers and quarterback Jordan Love agree to a one-year contract extension through the 2024 season. The deal is worth up to $22.5 million, including $13.5 million guaranteed, according to ESPN's Adam Schefter. The team also restructures the contract of safety Darnell Savage. Love will be the starter. Rookie Sean Clifford could be the backup. Brian Gutekunst need a veteran quarterback to fill out the room.
We'll probably see how these guys do before we think about bringing in a veteran right away.
Packers begin a rookie minicamp on Friday. And the Brewers begin a six-game road trip tonight in Colorado against the Rockies. You can hear the game on 620 WTMJ with coverage beginning at 7:05. Milwaukee 18-10 on the season. The Rockies are 9-20. This sports update presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams. Member FDIC.
You are listening to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Life, heaven, thinking that he met you in a past life. Sweatpants, hair tied, chilling with no makeup on. That's when you're the prettiest. I hope that you don't take it wrong. You don't even trip when friends say you ain't bringing Drake along. You know that I'm working, I'll be there soon as I make it home. Is she a patient in my waiting room? Never pay attention to the rumors and what they assume. And until them girls prove it, I'm the one to never get confused with. Cause baby, you my everything. You all I ever wanted. We could do it real big, bigger than you ever done it. You be up on everything, another whole thing never on it. I want this forever, I swear I could spend whatever on it. Cause she hold me down every time I hit up. When I get right, I promise that we gon' live it up. She made me beg for it till she give it up. And I say the same thing every single time. I say you the, you the best. You the, you the best.
What up, y'all? We back. And Penfield Children's Center Behavior Clinic is now accepting new patients in Milwaukee and Waukesha counties. Serving children up to age 6, Penfield's in-home mental health treatment and model addresses behavior concerns and provides therapy for traumatic or stressful events. Our evidence-based model teaches parents and caregivers new skills and responses to address their child's challenging behaviors or emotional concerns. We were talking about the Kia boys earlier. I think a lot of them would benefit from some sort of mental health assessment, treatment, etc. Either way, visit penfieldchildren.org/behavior-clinic. Again, that's penfieldchildren.org/behavior-clinic for more information or to request a free phone consult. We're talking about when you dress to impress, when you are doing it for the gram, when you are doing it up, showing up and showing out. Who are you showing up for and who are you showing out for? That is the question. I can't wait to hear the guys' response. We do have two people on the line, so we're going to go ahead and talk to them before we hear from the guys. Good afternoon. We've got Alan on the line first. How you doing? And who is it that you try to get dressed up for, if anybody?
Well, hey, first, I don't try to get dressed up. I get dressed up. When I go out, when my wife and I go out, it, it's we go all in. I don't play around. I'm an older guy. I got what I got. And when I run in, like if we go to a fundraiser or we go anywhere like that, a gala or something, I know how to do what I'm doing. I'll put on the watch. I'll put on the shoes. The fitted, you know, the good suit, the shirt with the monograms, my ring, different glasses. You know, I go out, do the hair. If I'm out in the wintertime, it's a cashmere top coat.
Look at you. You got rings, the monogram.
Ain't no joke. The ring I had to do because my wife told me. I got two. I got one I wear, and then I got the real one. Same with the watches. You know, you wear your watches, then when you go out sometimes when you're around certain people, you have to, you know, you got to look the part. You got to be the part if you're going to pretend to be the part.
Okay.
So who are you doing it for?
My wife.
Is it for your wife or is it
for your
people?
I'm doing it for my wife, really. And other people who know who I am, because you can go around being who I am, like looking like a bum. And the places we go, you know, if you're running around certain areas, they're going to know whether you belong there or not. And if you belong there, they know you got cake.
Okay, knowing you got cake. Wait, Alan, I wish we had more time because he was just dropping random little nuggets that I really wanted to keep hearing. Alan, unfortunately, we only have so much time, but really appreciate you calling in. Yes to dressing up for the wifey, and yes to correcting me and saying, I don't try, I does. Period, Alan. I really liked your vibe. All right, we got Al next. Hey, Al, how you doing? I think this is our first time talking to you on Nothing But the Truth. How's your day going?
Al's free.
Hey, yeah, I heard about the trial. I heard about the trial.
The trial?
Do you get it? Ah, yeah. Little pun for you. Pun gun. Pew, pew. Okay, go ahead, Al. What's up?
Well, usually when I go out, I dress for myself so they can trial and they can spend that cake. But you got to know your audience and you got to have your motive or what you're trying to get, because some of the onlookers you might not want and some of the spectators is the ones you might keep. So you dress for the occasion. That's what I do. So just in case if one or two wants to buy, that's three, but it's even better if it's four. And if the ones who is willing, you tell them, come on, too. Because if they all spilling the KK, that's even better for you.
Period.
What is the KK? If they're all spilling the KK.
No, spending
that?
The cake. Like, I'm, listen,
spending the cake.
I want to flee.
What is
I want them lining up. You feel me? Thank you, Al. Al, what's understood doesn't need to be explained. Appreciate you.
I was trying to understand what the cake means.
I know,
okay.
But Al, you don't need to understand. You don't need to understand.
I know.
I'm just kidding.
I'm out in them rooms that you, Al, and Alan are in.
We in different rooms. But right now, we in the same room. So I need to ask y'all the same question. Kyle, Ben, I know we discussed this a little bit off air, but I'd love for you to say it to the listeners. Who is it that you are trying to impress when you are dressing up?
Yeah, so, I mean, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. We talked about it, and when I get dressed up, and let me tell you something, I really don't care too much about what other people think because I don't put that much effort into what I do because I'm just trying to make it through each day. But when I do dress up, I do it for other people. I don't really do it for me. Like, a lot of times when I am confident in myself, when I look at the mirror, I say, you know what, Kyle? You're a solid 6.5, 7. You are solid! You are solid, Kyle.
And Kyle, why would you do that? Why would you say that?
I am a solid 6.5 and 7.
You should be a 10 every day.
Listen.
Or you should strive to be a 10.
There's a lot of fours out here. So me being a solid 7, I'll take it.
Are you a Wisconsin 7? Because, you know, there's
no,
like
I'm
a.
I'm a national 7.
There's like a Kentucky
7.
9
no.
versus an LA 4. I just want to know.
I am a national 7.
I'm just kidding. 7. I'm just kidding, Kentucky. I only said y'all because Maya sent us an email about the Kentucky Derby.
Going to the Derby.
Sorry.
I am a national 7, and I'm good with that. That's above average looking man. And so what I'm saying is when I get dressed up, I like getting attention from others that validates me saying, yeah, I still got it. Yeah, I still look good. So when I work out and I do all this stuff, I don't do it for me. My lady likes to feel my arms and my muscles that I try to put on. I do it for her. I don't do it so much for me. And when I dress up in a certain way and look good, I do it so my lady think I look good. Or when people see me out, they're like, oh, that's a cute shirt or that's this or that's that. I do it for other people. I don't really do it for me. It's not about me. It's about y'all. I want to aesthetically look good to the world.
What about you, Ben?
That is so beautiful, Kyle. You want to aesthetically look beautiful to the world. That's beautiful.
Facts.
You know.
He said, I'm just trying to make the world a better place.
Yeah.
One outfit at a time.
And you are. You know, I heard you say you call yourself a 6 or 7. But you know what? End of the day.
Said 6.5, 7. 7.
I feel you, dog.
No, I'm not a 6.
Well, all I'm trying to say is because at the end of the day, women don't really care about looks. Women care about your bank account. So once they see your bank account, then Kyle, you know, then you like a 10,000. You know what I'm saying? But I digress, because this isn't about that. This is about how I feel and who I'm getting dressed for.
I mean, you do present a very interesting point, though. Do women care more about the bank account than anything else?
Yes, they care. I think they do.
Bank account.
I think you do. No,
not just you, but a lot of women care more about the bank account than they do the looks.
100%. 100%.
Remember, what's her face? The sisters. Tamar was dating Vince, the big dude. Vince wasn't the best looker, but Vince had the money.
Had the bag. That's all that matters, though.
But what's wrong with that? Because don't you want to be comfortable?
She's defending it. There we go. That's all we needed to know.
I'm not defending. I am asking a question.
What's wrong with owning money being important?
I think it is important.
Money's important to y'all, too, right?
Look, money isn't everything, but it's damn near
up
there with
oxygen.
It's
not everything, but it's important. We got to be comfortable. I'm trying to live a certain way. I'm not trying to struggle. Why would I have only one life to live and struggle?
Google what Vince looks like.
Vince who?
Vince Tamar Braxton's ex-husband. You Google what he look like as Ben finishes. I'll do it for you.
Well, listen, I'm not about to knock her idea of attractive. I don't even want to see him.
Eyes in the beauty of the beholder. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
There we go. So it is what it is. I don't think there's anything wrong with marrying for money as long as you're also attracted to that person's personality.
All right, future male's husband.
I'm just saying, like, who?
Just know what it's about to be.
Who on earth would get married?
Better get
like,
the prenup.
You know what? I'm trying to be broke for the rest of my life.
Hey.
Like, who says that? Just because I'm brave enough to actually say what everybody's thinking, Ben.
That's Vince. Would you marry Vince? Okay. Lord Jesus.
He's not my cup of tea.
He has money, Mel.
I don't care.
How rich is he, Kyle? You gotta have money.
And I gotta like you.
Vince got money. Show the world.
He got money.
Like.
Vince got money.
But this is why I
pick
say
his belly up
you can't marry solely for money. I need to be attracted to who you are as a human. Okay.
I guess when that bank account come out, I think you can be a lot more attractive.
But I'm gonna tell you right now, unless I'm desperate, you won't catch me with someone I'm not attracted to. I have to be attracted to you.
Sure.
Ben!
Hey, what she say? Money make me what? Don't say it, Ben!
Why are you putting my business out there?
Play the song when we come back.
Why are you putting my business out there?
It's all good. But in all honesty, at the end of the day, who do I get dressed for? Personally, I get dressed for opportunity. That's what I get dressed for. I get dressed for opportunity. I learned a long time ago that, you may lose out on opportunities based on how you dress. So all those young men out there who decide to still sag their pants, I'm telling you, you are missing out on so much opportunity, whether it comes down to women or an actual job opportunity that could possibly change your life. I've talked to some nice people out there in the world just based off of how I dress. So, hey, that's all I'm going to say.
Ben, I love that. I agree that he said that.
When I know, like WBA awards we have on Saturday, when I
dress up, you gonna be in a suit, right?
Yeah, we looking good. Like period. I know when I look good. No, I know when I look good, and period. I know that's why I like to get.
Is that when
the
you're gonna be a 10?
I mean 10 in a lot of people's eyes. Like that. Like I know for a fact that video that we put on LinkedIn. Follow us on LinkedIn. 101.7 The Truth. I knew I looked good that day.
Period.
I knew I did. I had on a turtleneck. I had on a nice pants. I knew I looked good that day. Like I know when I look good. You know, and that's why I do it for others, and I do it for my baby especially.
That's so sweet. Real quick, I got two things I want to say to y'all before we take a break, and we're going to get to our last segment. Spike Lee is choosing violence at the end of the show. He texted us at 833-212-1017. Again, that's why we got passport bros. Mel's the reason. Not the reason for y'all to have passport, bro.
Yeah, they mad. That's that.
I ain't struck, got nothing
struck
to do
a nerve
with that.
There.
That's these Milwaukee women.
My money go further in Argentina, Colombia,
Brazil, El Salvador. You so crazy, Kyle.
In Mexico.
I don't know any person.
Nigeria.
In their right mind, who would honest to goodness be okay with being broke and struggling and living paycheck to paycheck for the rest of their life.
Nobody's talking broke. Nobody's saying that. But just know that like 70% of millennials live paycheck to paycheck, right, man?
Of course. course.
That's what definitely heard on the show.
Kyle, knowing that, why would you want that for the rest of your life? No, I'm trying to be comfortable at some point. I'm trying to start generational wealth at some point. You feel me?
That's
why would I want my kids to struggle?
We can talk about later.
All right,
maybe
you're
even
right.
On the other side.
All right, you're right, you're right, you're right. I'm sorry. And you know what else is right? LabCorp has a variety of open trials now that will fit your schedule. They got two different studies, one for healthy adults between 18 and 60 with a BMI between 18 and 32. The study involves two stays totaling 15 nights, seven follow-up visits. Compensation up to $13,820 may be provided for time and participation. Receive up to $300 per qualified participant. They also have a trial, where they're looking for healthy overweight males and females between 18 and 55. Females must be of non-childbearing potential with a BMI between 30 and 39.9. Study involves one stay, 35 nights, three follow-ups, with compensation up to $15,996 that may be provided for time and participation. Receive up to $500 per qualified participant and visit LabCorpClinicalTrials.com to learn more. Also, I know for a fact that you wanted more than just a house. You wanted a place where your kids would feel totally protected, be free to dream of what's possible, explore their passions, maybe even follow up in your footsteps. AKA generational wealth. Nobody understands that more than American Family Insurance, and that's why they protect the dreams of the next generation. You can save up to 23% when you bundle home and auto. Get a quote, find an agent, learn about their discounts by visiting amfam.com.
All your favorite interviews and best moments live in one place.
You know, I'm working in the morning and I was listening back on the Truth app.
Download the new 1017 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk 1017 The Truth.
This is 1017 The Truth's Telly Hughes, and the time is now, Milwaukee. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is a show that's committed to creating a healthy space and dialogue every single morning for full transparency when it comes to issues and perspective through the African-American lens. So listen to Truth Be Told with me, Telly Hughes, every day from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
They, of course, have never met in person. Ricardo has been stuck in Canada. How do you get stuck in Canada?
He went there for a job.
I go to Canada all the time. I never been stuck. Does he know you're here?
No, he does not.
Surprise! You go to food banks, but you're feeding his Beverly Hills maid.
Yes.
What kind of no good son of a bitch will take money from a woman? All new Dr. Phil.
Hi, I'm Natalie Shepard.
And I'm Jessup Reisbeck from the CBS 58 News at 10.
We hear it all the time from viewers. Television news is too negative.
That's why we're trying something different at CBS 58. In our newscasts, we focus on what's important to Southeast Wisconsin, and that's not necessarily crime.
We want you to know the great things happening in our hometowns as well.
What's going to help solve problems here and uplift our viewers?
We are your hometown station, and that's the type of news we're going to bring to you.
Join us every night at 10 on the CBS 58 News.
All Brewers games are on sale now. Next up, the crew battles the Royals for a weekend duel. Friday, May 12th through Sunday, the 14th. Fulfill your Jedi destiny at Star Wars Night on Saturday, the 13th. And receive a Yuke Skywalker bobblehead with purchase of a special ticket package. Plus, take home a one-of-a-kind Brewers wristlet for 10,000 moms on Mother's Day. Sunday, May 14th. Presented by American Family Insurance. Get your seats today at brewers.com/promotions.
This is 1017 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 1017 The Truth, Milwaukee Black. Talk.
Bringing all the smoke to you.
I love what you're doing, and this radio station is just like what it's called. It's the truth.
Download the new 1017 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 The Truth.
You are listening to Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Make sure you Tune in to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris tomorrow as he will broadcast live from the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Milwaukee College Signing Day, sponsored by Direct Supply. Dr. Ken will speak with representatives from the local Boys and Girls Club about the 90 scholars who earned over $15 million worth of scholarships to attend college. Again, that is Truth in the Afternoon live from the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Milwaukee College Signing Day tomorrow, Wednesday, May 3rd at 4 p.m. on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
That part. Also, to put down strong roots, a little support goes a long way. When you work with someone that knows our communities as well as Associated Bank, you get financial guidance that fits your life. They use financial knowledge to build solutions that make a difference, from a personal loan to a new home. And they're ready to help you grow stronger roots. All you have to do is go to associatedbank.com/lending. Member FDIC. So, this was a very fun show. I absolutely love the topic. I actually would love y'all to go ahead and tease right now, because y'all really did inspire something in me. I want to talk about who are the best rappers of all time tomorrow.
Got it.
Sorry. And I know we like doing our hot takes, so it's giving hot takes. This is my top five.
Let's go!
You ready? Do you want the smoke, Ben? I need y'all to have your top five favorite rappers, best rappers of all time, ready for our show tomorrow. We appreciate you. Have a great rest of your Tuesday.
Saying they love me, but one in my place. Step in the party, I'm looking the baddest. So the paparazzi in my face. Pretty, but I came from the gutter. Said I'd be lit by the end of the summer. And I'm proud that I'm still getting bigger. Going viral is getting them sicker.
What's good, y'all? This is 101.7 The Truth's Telly Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. The goal of Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is to provide a platform for citizens of Milwaukee and Truth Nation to have their voices heard about concerns that have daily direct impact. So join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Tory Lowe, and the time is now, Milwaukee. I believe the people who listen to the Tory Lowe Show are ready for real change in the community and love to bring all the smoke. Tap in, Truth Nation, to the Tory Lowe Show every day from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com. The movement continues. Milwaukee Black Talk.
April is Financial Literacy Month, and according to the FINRA, 60% of Wisconsin residents can't answer basic financial literacy questions, and over half are living paycheck to paycheck. Secure Futures is here to change this by equipping teens with transformative money management skills.